Okay, so today we have some more fun and interesting stuff to do. What I'm going to do is look at these bees, and we're seeing bees actually bearded and massed on the outside of our beehives. And this is happening all over the apiary now. We have cold mornings, and we have an abundance of bees in the workforce in these colonies. So what they do is they forage out through the day. They're bringing in so much nectar and so many resources that the workforce actually moves outside the hive and collects on the side. If you notice on the landing board here too, that's what's called bearding, when they hang and collect underneath. The energy level of these bees is very low when they're on the outside, and the reason is because they want to conserve their resources. And here at the landing board at this reducer, you'll notice that these bees are just fanning their wings as fast as they can. And that's because the humidity levels inside the hive are extremely high right now, as is the heat. Speaking of heat, look at this thermal image of the landing board. And you can see that that lightest color, dead center, is the vent to the hive. And you'll see that they are sending out temperatures that go all the way up into the 80s. While if you look at the right-hand scale here, there are portions in the field of view here that are down to 40 and even 39 degrees. So it's a cold day out there. Now, what's the temperature of the bees that are collected on the outside, and are all of their bodies the same temperature? Well, we're going to find out with this thermal imager. All the way up to 84.2 now at the sensor in the dead center of the field of view there. This is just a close-up of the bees beating on the landing board, of course, as I mentioned before. Now this is the eastern side, and what we have going on here, notice their outstretched forelimbs as they cling to that telescoping top. What happens is, once they lock their little feet on there, they're using almost no energy. It's a latching mechanism that's in the design of the bee's feet, that once they hook into something, they can hold on without expending energy to do that. So now we're going to take a look. First of all, this is a couple inches thick, and the bees are just heavy duty out here. And we're going to also take a look thermally at whether or not all of these bees have the same temperature and are using the same energy at the same time. It's a lot of bees. Now, I don't know what's going on this year, but this fall, all of my hives have generated huge numbers of workers. And they're bringing in nectar at an incredible rate. But let's see the thermal image. Now look at this. The dark purple and blue areas, of course, are the colder bees, all the way down to 60, 61 degrees. And you'll notice if you look at the scale to the right on this screen, it says 82, 83. So some of these hot spots, some of the warmer bees that are active, are actually have a body temperature at temps in the 80s. So this is really interesting to look at, those that are conserving. And of course, it's early morning, so these bees are waking up and starting to move, and this is the east side, so it's going to get the sunlight first. But it's very interesting to be able to look at these with a thermal image and see that there are hot-bodied bees in this group and others that are still virtually dormant, and they're allowing their body temperatures to get down to 60 or 59, 58 degrees in order to conserve energy on the outside of the hive. And again, that upper left temperature that's bobbing around 71 degrees, 73, 76, those are the temperatures at the circle in the dead center of the field of view here. And then, of course, the background temperature is 46 degrees, so it's a cold morning. Now, this is a valuable tool because we can look at beehives in the apiary and look at the hotspots, we can tell which hive bodies are occupied and generating the most heat. And of course, the more bees, the more heat they're generating. And again, they've collected on the outside of the hives because it's actually too hot inside and the humidity levels are too high. So they're getting the air out. And of course, here's a yellow jacket trying to get in unsuccessfully. But look again, this is another hive. Look at the number of bees that are collected on the outside. It's too hot and it's too humid inside. These are field bees. And again, the venting that's coming out is in the 80s. But we're going to look at bee body temperatures and see that there are heater bees and those that are remaining cool in the morning air. And just look at the little hot spots moving around here. It's very interesting to have this tool. And again, if you look upper right on the scale, some of these hot spots are up to 93 degrees, and this is on the outside of the hive in a morning where the temperature is in the high 30s, low 40s. Now, something I want you to notice, when you see the bees moving around and then you see the yellow dot that appears showing their temperature, which is offset from the physical parameters of the bee, that's because this camera uses parallax lensing. One of the lenses is the lower, well, one of the lenses shoots lower, and that is just for the image, and then the lower lens on the camera is offset a little so it gathers heat or shows the heat print. And that's why you see the bees moving off to the left here and then the little yellow dots above them. We have two lenses at play here to give us this compound image that we're looking at. But what a great tool. We're going to be able to look at our hives and immediately know, number one, if they're occupied. Number two, how strong the hive is and how much temperature elevation is occurring at the entry board and at that reducer. So we're going to know that the bees are doing well inside or not. And this is a front, and I'll, of course, show you the camera because some of you are probably dying to know. This is a Flir C2, and it's a handheld, self-contained thermal imaging camera. It can also take normal pictures. If you look at the front here, the upper lens is for the normal picture capture, and the lower, larger diameter lens is the thermal imaging lens. Also, off to the side there, you see that it has a light built into it for flash or for a constant light so that you can see what it is you're looking at. The camera does not collect video on its own. It only collects still images. So I made the video by running another camera up against the screen so that we can get a live view of what's going on with these honeybees. But I'm just beginning to explore all the different things I'm going to be able to do with this little C2 camera. Center button on top is for taking the still picture, and that's the on-off button. This thing goes in your pocket. It's pretty heavy duty the way it's made. It has a nice bumper built around it, and I'm super happy with it. The weather's about to turn. It's going to get bad. Winter's going to come in. The bees are going to need that pollen for the protein to grow and develop, and they're also going to be needing to bring in as much nectar as they can before winter arrives full force. I hope you enjoyed this video. And I hope that you got something out of it. Thermal imaging is going to be a terrific tool for me here in my apiary as we learn more about the honeybees and their energy consumption. Thanks as always for watching.